Everything was all good. Way back in the day, then the whole hood just went wild. What's up? So today I'm going to show you how to do a reverse velocity VHS transition. Keep in mind you will need Universe plugins and Sapphire plugins for this effect. So I've chosen the song Lost Files by Polo G, right? I've already marked out my beat drops and parts of the song. So the first and last marker are going to be my first and second kill, and then these two middle ones is going to be where that transition happens. So I'll play out what I have marked.
Everything was all good way back in the day, then the whole hood really went wild.
So as you can see, that's what I have, and now I'm going to go over what I'm going to do with the effects. You're going to want to use audio effects here in your effects library, and we're going to be using reverb quite frequently here. So I'm going to turn on my magnet tool. I'm gonna cut on my first kill, and I'm gonna go to around where he starts talking. I'm gonna left click, hold alt, drag down, makes a copy. I'm gonna fade in the bottom one like this, and fade in the top one like this. I'm gonna add reverb to the bottom clip. This pop up should pop up for reverb. I'm gonna wanna make this roughly 50 for the dry wet scale, so X that out. And then we're gonna wanna make the reverb clip a little bit quieter, so it depends on the song. But you're gonna wanna tune the reverb audio down a little bit. Then we're gonna wanna cut on the two transition points like this. Again, left click, alt drag down, makes a copy. And this one's gonna be a little bit different. We're gonna delete the top clip, and then we're gonna zoom in more. We're gonna overlap the first or the regular audio over, and we're gonna overlap the reverb audio over like that. And then we're gonna do the same on the end of it. So go like that, and here we're gonna fade this in like this, fade this in like this, and you can use that little black box that says like 7 frames to line up your fade ins, which is what I'm doing. And you're gonna wanna drag reverb on this, dry wet around 50, save it, and then make the volume of this clip down just a little bit. So then we have should have something that sounds like this.
Everything was all good way back in the day, then the whole hood really went wild. Long live the gang.
So as you see, the reverb kind of cuts in and out on the kill for a build up and for a transition. So I'm gonna go sync up some clips. You guys should know how to do this. This is more of an intermediate tutorial, and I'll catch back in with you guys. Alright guys, so back, finished linking up my two clips, and this is what it looks like right now. There is a blank spot in the middle, and you'll see why that is. That's where the reverse will go, but this is what I've done so far. So, nothing much, just velocity and syncing, right? So, what you're going to want to do next is you're going to want to seek your second clip, which will be the reverse bit going into your second clip, right? So you want to turn on your magnet, you want to drag your second clip from where it is synced. So you might want to actually mark where it was synced just so you can keep that spot, but you're going to want to drag it back into your blank space as far as you can without overlapping. And right where your transition point is in the song, you're going to want to control B or use the blade tool and cut there. And then you're going to want to select this bit. You're going to want to drag it back to where the magnet was, and you're going to want to click on this, left click, alt drag, and drag this back into place, and it'll all line up. So you have this first bit of the clip right here, both of these playing twice. So it like looks laggy right now, right? But it's repeating. So on the first one, you want to right click, change clip speed, and you want to put a negative sign in front of this. So just like that, hit change, replace, and this is what it'll look like then. Alright guys, then you're gonna want to drag an adjustment clip right here, drag it on your timeline, right? I already have mine set up here. So what you're really gonna want to do is once you drag in your adjustment clip, like so, you're gonna want to size it up with what is happening. So right here is my reverse bit. So this is where I want the VHS to be. So I'm gonna go right here, just lay it right over the middle, and I'm gonna cut right here and right here. So I have it perfectly sized up like that. And also, you can just overlap it out. I'd say like 5 frames on either side, just so you can have a little fade in, fade out, make it look a little cleaner, just like that. And then you're gonna want to go into Fusion, right? So you're gonna want to copy the settings I have here. You're gonna ignore keyframes. Don't worry about that stuff. And this is what you're gonna want. So just run through these settings, copy all these down. Feel free to pause the video if you need. Now, a lot of these values haven't changed, only some of them have, so keep that in mind. There's not as much as it looks like to change, but you can reuse this over and over as a preset, right? So, I'm gonna go back here, and now we have our reverb, our clips synced, and our universe VHS. So, I'm gonna wait for this to render, and then I will show you what it looks like when it has done so. Alright, so it's rendered. This is what it looks like for me, but I am actually gonna add a few changes. So it looks pretty nice, right? But I'm going to want to add a little bit more of a lead-in right here. Just a little bit more, because I'm gonna want to add a cross dissolve to these bottom clips. I'm only gonna want to make it around 15 seconds long, but just so we have a smooth lead into this clip. So we'll have a build up for the first clip, then a nice lead into the cross dissolve, and that is what you're gonna have. I'm gonna go through now, add some of my shake presets, some of my own assets, and show you what it looks like then. And you should do the same. It'll make it look way nicer. You don't want to leave it just like this. But that is going to be it for the transition. So we're going to go a little bit backwards today. I did the transition first. Now we're going to go do this kill build up here. So once you've done this with the transition, you want to click on it again, alt drag it over. So you're going to have the same effects here, right? You're going to want to get rid of these fade ins, fade outs, right? You're going to want to put it right over where your song is. You're gonna wanna cut it on the kill. You're gonna wanna size it up with the audio, so right when the reverb starts coming in, and you're just gonna do a nice big fade in. You wanna fade in like, I'd say, two thirds of it, and then this end part you're gonna want to stay like this. So, pretty simple, right? You're just keeping the same effects, and that will give you a nice VHS buildup. I'll wait for it to render, and then I will show you what it's like when it's done rendering. So it's rendered for me. I'm gonna show you what it looks like, and after I show you, I'm gonna add some of my own shakes on it and clean it all up. You should do the same, but then it will look a lot better. You don't want to just keep it as bare bones effect. You want to add to it, you want to build off of it, right? So this is what it looks like for me. So hopefully this helped, and I will see you guys in the next video. Comment any other effects you guys would like to see, and thanks for watching.